It's almost unreal what MiHoYo has done with Volbeto's and Yula's banners, and this is the best time to investigate the whole situation. If you thought you knew what was going to happen with 2.3 dual banners, well, think again, because most of us assume that both Volbeto and Yula will be getting their own separate featured 4 stars, when instead they will be sharing them together. This is honestly a bit of a shocking reveal, and you'll understand the intensity of this situation even more when you get to the second part of the video, but for now, let's look at the details we've been shown so far. So basically, Bennett, Noelle, and Rosaria are going to be the featured 4 stars on both Volbeto's and Yula's banners, which means the only deciding factor is going to be the 5-star you want to go after and nothing else. Or, in other words, we're only getting an increased frequency of 5-star reruns, while those of you who are looking forward to have a chance at a greater selection of featured 4-stars will have to accept the fact it's not happening and to just live with it. At this point, it's unclear why MiHoYo decided to make it this way, and it almost feels flawed after playing plenty of other gacha games, since they could've just literally put in the 4-stars that actually have good synergy with the featured 5-stars, but now instead it's kind of a mixed bag. On one hand, it's great because you're only left with a choice which 5-star you want to go after, but then again, a lot of people take into consideration the 4 stars that are featured on the banner, since not everyone has enough Primo Gems or have their pity prepared to pull for the character, so losing out on 4 star variety and lumping the same ones together with Yula and Volbeto won't really be beneficial for these types of players. And if this is the way MiHoYo is intending to handle dual banners, it's going to be interesting to see what will be the next shared 4 stars, especially considering now that we know the next upcoming characters, who are going to be the 2 new Polearm users, both of which will coincidentally belong to Cryo and Geo, just like Volbeto and Yula. Honestly, it's probably best to reserve judgment for now and just focus on the actual opportunities these banners are willing to offer, especially considering what's coming up in this next part. Another big surprise that comes with these 2.3 dual banners is the featured weapon from the upcoming Dragonspine event, and if you truly want to understand why this is actually a huge deal, we need to get a little bit of context. So the new Cinnabar Spindle is a free-to-play sword anyone can obtain by just doing the event, and in the past, we've seen rewards like these show up for a total of 4 times, like Festering Desire, which was truly a beacon of light for people who struggled with maintaining their energy recharge on characters like Benny or Xingqiu, but then Windbloom Oath came out, which was a decent option to run instead of Stringless on characters like Fendi or Fischl. The same could also be said for Dodoko Tales, which is a pretty good catalyst on Klee, Yenfei, or Ningguang, and as for the Luxurious Sea Lord, well, it's an option almost any Claymore user could use as an alternative to Prototype Archaic. Obviously, there's also the catch, but it's not really a limited weapon, and you can obtain it anytime, so there's no real FOMO there. However, the whole point was to show you just how relevant these limited weapons were for several characters, and after finally seeing Cinnabar Spindle's stats and passive ability, it's kind of bizarre it's only usable on one character in the entire game. Because here's the thing, free rewards, especially weapons, are supposed to help out new and casual players with obtaining decent amount of power, but instead, MiHoYo is clearly focusing on driving up the sales for Volbeto, since he is the only one in the game who can benefit from the sword's substat and passive. But on the flip side, this sword does look extremely powerful in him, to the point that it's more than likely it will have razor-thin performance margin when compared to other top 5-star weapons like Jade Cutter or Mistsplitter, and it's all thanks to the absurd passive, which at first refinement will increase his overall elemental skill damage by 40%. But if the trend continues the same way as with every 5th weapon refinement, then you can expect this number to be doubled at 80%. Basically, what we're looking at here is almost the same scenario we're experiencing with the new 4-star characters. It's a special sword that has a niche purpose, so only the right type of unit can capitalize on it, and it's kind of a conflicting feeling. On one hand, it's pretty nice to see a specialized weapon if you're a veteran player who has unlocked decent amount of characters and weapons, which might push you over the edge to wish on Volbeto's banner if you haven't got him already, but on the other hand, this also means less opportunities for beginners and casuals to get some awesome weapons like we've seen in the past. I mean, maybe the whole idea of using free 4-star weapons as means to promote featured 5-stars is decent enough, and it might make the occasional wishing on that character even more special, but I guess we'll need to see how much of an actual impact this kind of strategy will have once we see the sales numbers. Still, if you're thinking of wishing for Volbeto, this weapon looks pretty insane, although keep in mind, Harbinger of Dawn is still out there as a perfectly viable choice, but Cinnabar Spindle will more than likely crush it in performance, especially if you can manage to balance his critical rate and damage ratio. Now that both Eula and Albedo will be sharing the same featured 4 stars, upon closer examination, it's pretty clear these characters were handpicked for a very specific reason. And aside from Betty Boy, who obviously works for almost any team as a flexible option, he is basically here acting as the icebreaker to even consider these banners, if you care about unlocking him or his constellations. But things definitely get more interesting with the remaining two, Rosaria and Noelle. There's no synergy between Noelle and Eula, which is exactly the same thing you could say for Rosaria and Albedo. However, Eula with Rosaria and Albedo with Noelle do actually work together with some caveats here and there. So, to put it simply, while the pool of 4-star characters is shared, it is a bit flawed if you're trying to get as much synergy as possible from just one 5-star banner. And I wouldn't even say these featured 4-stars are critical to either of them, because Eula's main priority is pairing her with a strong duo buddy like Fischl, Raiden, or Beto to enable super conduct reactions, while it's usually Diona who supplies her with cryo energy, because Rosaria's two biggest appeals to Eula is her critical boosting passive and the final constellation. And if we talk about Albedo, then his actual best buddies for Geo are Ningguang and or Zhongli, since they tie in really well with his damage rotation, and it's more than likely Ito and Goro will benefit from him even more. Now, the reason why Noelle and Albedo have issues functioning together purely from a meta perspective is that they both struggle with generating energy, since Noelle's elemental skill actually creates zero particles, and the alchemist himself has to rely on luck because of how his bloom elemental skill generates particles. So as a duo, they will have a lot of energy troubles, and it rests on the shoulders of the third Geo member, if we talk about mono team potential, which are going to be either Ningguang or the Traveler. Also, Noelle is one of those few rare exceptions where you definitely want to have her all constellations unlocked, because the last one is a huge game changer for her damage output performance. But it really all comes down to Goro's energy generation if you'll want to fully utilize the duo of Noelle and Albedo, especially if she will manage to compete with full constellation build against C0 Ito's damage potential. In all honesty, it feels like Albedo's banner is aimed towards veteran players who are thinking of exploring mono Geo teams, or wish to use Albedo as an absolutely cracked support damage dealer, together with his new sword and artifacts set, while Eula's banner looks more beginner friendly, since you can easily assemble a team with her, Rosaria, and Bennett. Aside from the fact you'll need one of those electro supports to keep those superconducts active, while also keeping in mind that Eula does require a good amount of investment to see the payoff. But shoving aside meta for a moment, if you don't care about synergy, big damage numbers, or the abyss, then there's not much to decide for you aside from either wishing or skipping on these two new banners. Although at the same time, you shouldn't feel pressured to pull for Albedo just because his event sword is available, even if it looks pretty awesome. Always remember this, MiHoYo and many other gacha companies literally hire gaming psychologists to help determine how to make you spend more Primo Gems, so be sure to only wish in characters you see yourself enjoy using in the game. I mean, there's a reason why they always carefully announce the next new characters right before the update goes live. The newest reveals we saw about 2.3 update has already been full of intrigue, but if that's not enough, even the weapon banner is kind of interesting. Now, if you're struggling with deciding between on which featured 5-star character banner to wish on, well, the good news are, there's not much to think about this weapon banner, since the 4-stars aren't really that great if we talk about their multi-purpose potential, because weapons like Lion's Roar and Dragon's Bane are really niche options, while Sacrificial Greatsword together with Wine and Song are pretty much lacking to provide any sort of advantage. So the only one that has some relevance is Ally Hunter, which you can use on support characters like Fischl or Aloy, maybe even Ganyu if you're willing to go that far. The only redeeming factor about this banner are the 5-stars, since both Freedom Sworn and Song of Broken Pines are extremely good on certain characters. In fact, it's kind of surprising to see Freedom Sworn featured here, since you have to assume it's something Albedo can use, or maybe this suggests Kazuha's rerun might be happening in the next few updates, although it's more than likely the first consideration is the more realistic one, since you can in fact use this 5-star sword to boost your team's overall damage, and seeing how Albedo already acts as a support for the team, it's actually pretty easy to pull off the passive, but unless you're a massive whale, there's no reason to wish for Freedom Sworn just because you want Albedo to have it, especially now that we know Cinnabar Spindle exists. And as for the Broken Pines, yeah, it's the best in slot for Eula, but besides her, only Razor and Shinyan can benefit from the Claymore Morse bonuses. And keep in mind, if you're excited about the two new characters, who are basically going to rename the game's client to Polearm Impact next update, well, then it's hard to believe there's going to be any good weapons for them in this banner. All in all, this weapon banner is filled with specialist weapons, and with the way pity and the randomization works here, it's not really worth going after any of the revealed weapons here, unless you're dead set on obtaining upgrades for some of these characters. One last thing that's worth to consider would be the future dual banners. It's highly probable Xiao will be featured in the upcoming updates because of the Lantern Festival event and his deep connection to it, so it only makes sense for him to appear in one of the dual banners, and seeing how crazy popular Hu Tao's rerun banner was, one can only imagine the sort of the Cocoa Goat effect we can expect from Ganyu. So if you're excited about either of these two highly popular characters, especially now that dual banners is a thing, you might want to consider saving up those primos for future reruns. But who knows, maybe once we learn why Albedo is going crazy over here with cryo powers, people might just feel inclined to wish based on this one single thing alone. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video and wish you the best of luck on the new banners. Thanks for watching and see you soon.